So the talk I have divided into two major groups. The first hour and a half is where I'll be giving you a perspective. I won't be telling you something different, just a perspective to look at life in a different way. Then we will have a break. And after the break, I will give you a take on a journey of self-hypnosis, so that you can utilize this modality which you learn for relaxation and relief of some small problems that you face. Whatever I'll be talking is nothing very new. It has all been written in our old religious textbooks, the Vedas, the Granth, the Bhagavad Gita. But the problem is, because of lack of knowing the language of Sanskrit, we have lost that knowledge. And that same knowledge is being taken by the West and being presented under different names. Hypnosis, hypnotherapy is one such term. It is not very different from what you may be knowing about yoga, nidra and such other things. It is similar, but it is presented in a more scientific, so-called scientific or logical way. Now, when I begin, there is one question I would like to ask you. Who are you? and buy anything. Here means on earth. Let me put it in a different way. Suppose you are there in your house and somebody knocks on the door. You open the door and there is a stranger standing over there. So what is the first thing you'll ask? You don't know the person. You can ask, one on one, who are you? What do you want or why are you? Come and ask the same question. Who are you? Who are you? And why are we here or not? Any answers?
We are on this earth because this is not my control.
Okay.
We are gone. Yeah.
Maybe after talk, you will think differently. Right.
We are part of God Almighty and we are actually nothing.
No, we are everything. Don't believe it yourself. You are very important. Give the same answer you get from the stranger. Who are you? I don't know. Why are you here? I don't know. What will you think? You think, kaise pagal hai? Pata nahi kaun hai? Kyun aaya hai? Kab kyun kar? So actually we are also similar. We have come onto this earth. We don't know who we are. We don't know why we are here. And we are just running around. जो भी चमक दमक करके पीछे भागते हैं कभी आए क्या करते हैं टूवर्ड्स द लेटर पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ और व्हेन वी गेन अ बिट मोर मैच्योरिटी क्वेश्चंस कीप अराइजिंग व्हाई हैव आई कम हियर इज दिस व्हाट आई एम सपोज्ड टू डू इज दिस व्हाई आई वाज बोर्न. Is there some higher purpose of my being? So these questions come, the trouble is sometimes when we go back to the mundane living. So if we start off with the first question, who am I? So you are a physical self, a body. Within your body, you have a mind and you have a soul. Together, this constitutes who you are. The body is like a piece of cloth. So, what happens when you die? Body goes, is cremated, burned, buried. What about the mind? What about the soul? So the mind has got two major divisions. A smaller part, 10%, is what we call the conscious mind. The conscious mind is basically your awareness in the circumstance. What you remember, what you do, who you are in this world, who are your relatives, who are your friends, what you're supposed to do. That is a part of the conscious mind. The larger part is the subconscious. The subconscious mind is that part of you which we label as the sixth sense, the intuition, the inner voice. Also, if you take it, it is a storehouse of all your experiences. It is like a hard disk. And this hard disk is a part of the soul.
Hmm?
Okay. And what about the soul? The body is destroyed. The conscious mind finishes with the body. The subconscious attaches to the soul. And what happens to the soul? Marne ke baad atma kahan jata?
Lucky ones get both, otherwise you keep in the
soul. There is no such thing as that. There is no lack. It is all your karmas, which determines whether you get moksha or not. The soul, you all must be knowing, is an eternal life being, which doesn't die. It is a permanent entity, which takes birth again. Right? So, after you die, what happens to the soul? Where does the soul go? The other world. Which world?
Cosmic energy form.
Nahi jata hoga, it must be going somewhere. Where? See, remember, in this entire universe, this creation, everything has been planned to the minutest detail. The sun rises, the sunset, moon rises, the tides happen, the stars are there, their movement. Everything is planned to the minutest detail. So there can be nothing which is random. Everything is planned. It goes, for lack of a better word, let us say to the other side. The other side is also called heaven. It can be also called Shambhala, Garden of Eden, Paramdham. You can call it by any name. But what impression do you get about this place? When we talk about heaven, we talk about Paramdham. We get an impression that it is a place where there is everything is perfect. Perfect means there is no injury, no harm, no pain, only joy, enjoyment. And that is your home. And the soul is the true you. This, where you have come to this world, is just a school. So, if you call this a school, I call this a circus, but you can call this a school. So what do you do when you go to school? Why do you go to school?
To learn.
So in that world, the other side, where the soul stays, where everything is good, there is no death, there is no pain, everything is joy. Where you are enjoying yourself, you know everything. Why do you have to come here? So like a child enjoys himself at home, but you send him to school. And how does he go to school? He goes crying to school, the first time. Similarly, when you are born, you cry. And when you come to school, remember you come here to learn something. And what are the things you want to learn? What do you think you have come to learn? What are the things you come to learn?
Set right whatever wrongs you have done in the previous life.
Repay your karma, yes, to some extent. And school mein kuch seekhne jaane, yes?
Learn to forgive. See,
basically, you learn the higher emotions. Forgiveness, compassion, love, kindness, peace, humility, generosity. So these are all higher emotions which you come here to learn. It has nothing to do with money, fame. Because if you have lived 10,000 lives before, you have played all the roles. From the richest to the poorest, most famous to the most famous. A beggar, a robber, a soldier, a doctor. You have played all the roles. But most of the time, you have played the role of an ordinary human being. But as an ordinary human being, you learn the most. And you decide what you want to learn. So suppose over there, the other side, you decide decide that, okay, I cannot forgive people easily. I find it difficult. If somebody does wrong to me, I can't forgive. So I have to learn what exactly is the purpose. So this forgiveness, you want to know. So you have decided, you know the theory. You have to come here to actually give the practical and pass the practical. So you want to learn the lesson of forgiveness. In the other side, we have some people whom we call the masters, the guides, the devtas, the higher self, the angels. In different cultures, they are known by different names. Your higher self, your guide, all these different. So they help you to decide. You have already decided that you want to learn forgiveness. They help you. So they will write the script for you. Like a character or a script writer writes a script for you, where you are the main actor. So the script is decided and few options are given to you depending on the country, the mother you choose, place you choose, whether your lesson can be learned in this way. In the other side, you usually have a group of people who we call a soul group. 10, 15, 20 people who tend to reincarnate together, life after life. So sometimes they say, the wife, saath janmo ka saath hai. Actually it is true. The people who are there in your life are usually there in your life in different roles. Your father may have been your son, your husband, a friend, a cousin. The same people play different roles. Like a director has got favorite cast. It tends to cast the same people again and again in his movies. Your life is also a movie. Only thing if that is for 78 years. Normal movies stretch for 3 hours, 2 hours. So you want to learn the lesson of forgiveness? One of your soul groups says, okay, suppose you are a lady. Your soul person says, okay, I'll go down as a husband and I'll be a very bad husband. Let's see if you can forgive. So you only forgive if something bad happens. If everything good happens, what is there to forgive? So he says, I'll be a bad husband, let me see if you can forgive. So you are born over here, you have a very nice childhood, a very nice life, and you get married, and after some time, your husband starts loving. Doesn't take care of you, beats you, abuses you, doesn't come home, and you actually have a bad life. So you have an option now, you can leave him, but okay, you have children, you don't have any other support system. You carry on with him, always saying, God, please give me a better husband. You pass your life. And when you die, your husband asks you, I troubled you a lot, did you forgive me? No. How can I forgive you? You were very rude to me, very bad. Okay, no problem. Lesson not learned. Same lesson left, you are again born. As you are born, as a child, your mother passes and your father remarries and you get a step. And now she makes life better. Troubles you, doesn't give you to eat, beats you up. So the moment you become big, you leave home. And all your life you say, if my mother would have been alive, I would have been very much better off. I would have studied. It is because of this lady my whole life. And when you go up, same thing is asked. I troubled you a lot. Did you forgive me? No. You really troubled me. Okay, no problem. Third life, same lesson, still not learned. Come down, good childhood, good husband, children, nice life, enjoy. Children become big, they take your property, kick you out of the house, leave you, you are in old age home, nobody look after, nothing to eat, alone, crying, sick, saying, what it would have been better if I did not have to do, rather than different things.
When you go up, they ask,
did you forgive us? We troubled you alone.
Now for a moment, just look around and see. Every house,
mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, father, son, brothers, partners in business, friends, all fighting.
But if you look at the larger picture, they are only trying to teach you your lesson if you want it.
Agar koi bura nahi karega, so how will you forgive? And forgiveness is one of the most difficult lessons. So they always say they have done so bad to us, we don't want to see their face. Remember, there is nothing right or wrong in this world. Right or wrong is just a perspective. You may be a vegetarian, your husband is a non-vegetarian. Both of you come home very hungry. Look into the fridge, there's only one dish of chicken. Your husband becomes happy, you become sad. What is the problem with the chicken? It is the same dish. It is your perspective how you react to it. So, life over here is not numbered. You live life as only lessons. There is no such thing as time. If a soul doesn't die, time doesn't matter. It is only lessons. So, for example, you are born over here. And you are in class 6. I say class 6 of lessons learned. And this world, society, is actually a school where there are people from nursery to college. You are in 6. You know a few things, you don't know. Your friends will usually be around class 6. Those are more similar lessons. Like in school also, if you are in class 6, your friends are in class 6, 7 or 5. However, your family may be different. You don't lose your family. You may get married to a person who is in class 2. Spiritually. Now what happens? Suppose a class 6 person tries to teach a class 2, the subject of mathematics. Will the class 2 understand? Won't understand. Similarly, if you try to teach your husband or your wife who is in class 2, she will not understand. Similarly, suppose the husband enjoys dancing and partying the whole day. You think, what do they mean of this? What is calling it? But the child in class 2 knows only that he will do what he likes. Similarly, a person who is in class 12, suppose your son or daughter is in class 12, spiritual. She earns money and she gives it away. She spends it on other people. And you said, keep the money, you may require for our day, open a fixed deposit. Be more caring with your money. See that you keep it. You can't just blow it up. He says, it doesn't matter. I'll earn more. And I will see when time comes. You think, how will she survive? But she's already learned those lessons. But for you, you think, yes. Nursery to graduation is when we learn this. After you graduate, where do you go? When you graduate from school, you leave school. So when you graduate and you have learned all the lessons, you don't need to come back. And this is what we call as moksha or nirvana, freedom from the cycle of birth. So basically, when you know your lessons, you will not need to. Now, who are the people who are nursing? You also started off in nursery and eventually you will also by learning the lessons. before nursery, the souls are usually there in the animal. They start off from inanimate, then they go to the plant forms, then they go to the reptile, other forms, animal form, the higher animal forms. Eventually they will come into the human form. So when they come to the human form, suppose the first life, so what do they know? They only know what an animal knows. Like anything, snatch it. There are too many people gonna fight and flight. Imagine if you put that characteristic in the people in society, it will become clear to you, these are those people who live a very, he is like an animal. Murderers, rapists, druggists, don't care about economics. But then they have just come, they are here to learn and they will learn and they will learn. But what do? Put them in jail, treat them out. We also start. But that is good luck. And eventually they will learn and evolve. So society is actually a school. You are most comfortable with people who are in the same class. You get together and talk about people who are in a lower class and past judgment. That is what our television shows are all about nowadays, debating. The media debates, he's right, he's wrong, that's what it is. For every debate, you need to have a topic. You can speak for, you can speak against. Everybody has gone through debates in the schools where somebody has to speak for and somebody has to speak against. And suddenly your role changes. You say, okay, instead of for, you speak against. So you go and speak against. Actually, the matter is only a talk. And in life, if you keep opinions and judgments, there is bound to be conflict. You have an opinion which you believe is right. The other person has an opinion which he believes is right. You try to convince the other person. The other person tries to convince you. And you have a heated argument with a lot of emotions going on. High blood pressure, anger, strife, etc. So wherever there is an opinion, strong opinion, there is bound to be conflict. So instead of trying to make other people agree to your opinion, it is better to voice your opinion only when asked for. Or if somebody wants to go into an argument, don't react. That is. So now we come to the next two important words, react and respond. What is react? What is respond? We react a thousand times. React is when you create karma. Suppose I say, you are a doctor. You say, how dare you call me a donkey? You are also a doctor. You are a donkey. Your family is a donkey, your father is a donkey, your grandfather is a donkey. All of you are donkeys. How dare you bring my family into it? Most of the fights start in this way. This is the gap. Now suppose I say, you are a donkey. You say, that is your opinion, God bless you. You refuse to be drawn into the argument. That is it. It is a very subtle thing. But you see how many times you get. The maid comes late, you have to go out to office. People listening to her, you shout and maybe kick her out, or cut her sandwich or whatever. Whatever. You have increased your blood pressure. You have got angry. You have caused hurt to the other person. She has got negative. You are what negative. And now what is happening? All negative emotions manifest. Once the negative emotion has been created within your body, that negative emotion will eventually manifest. So, where do you create negative emotions? When you react, you create negative emotions. Second, we all have expectations, desires. Everything. Out of 10, maybe 8 expectations are fulfilled. You have the 9th one is not fulfilled. Suppose your anniversary is coming. You have seen a beautiful ring in the shop, and your husband has seen you walking. He said, "Okay, I'll get it for you on our anniversary." So anniversary is approaching. You remember that you're going to get that ring. You're very happy. The anniversary comes, husband goes to office, he's forgotten about it. In the office he remembers, okay, today is our anniversary. So he brings some flowers and some gifts. But you are waiting for that ring. He comes, gives you the flowers and wishes you happy anniversary. You say, okay, but in your mind what is happening? He did not bring you the ring. Initially he would have got me the ring, now he doesn't know. So he doesn't love me anymore. Then the thought will go wide. He's not coming home early also these days, he's staying out. Maybe he's having an affair also. Maybe something else. So these expectations that you have, desires that you have, which are not fulfilled, will cause hurt, frustration, anger, helplessness. So it happens again and again. Depression. Now, where have all these emotions been created? Within you. And what are the emotions going to do? So, you will feel uneasy. Uneasy, not at ease, dis-ease, that is disease. So initial, you get a headache. If it happens again and again, high blood pressure, chronic backache, irritable bowels. If it continues, diabetes, thyroid problems, migraine. It is these emotions and the thought process. It is actually the cause of all disease. Initially, it is these emotions which, if continued, will cause physical symptoms and they will manifest as disease in the body. See, your entire body is composed of cells. Your entire cells are in harmony with each other. Any negative energy, negative emotion will cause a loss of this harmony. This loss of harmony will make the cells uneasy. And that is disease. And what do we do? We get a pain in the joints. As you have got pain in the joint, arthritis. Arthritis, let us go and get our test. Go test them. With age, there is some space reduced. Okay, get a knee replacement. Or get something else done. Pain is a problem. And then you justify, your conscious mind justifies, and continue with it. In our system of medicine, we treat only the symptoms, the manifestations. But what is the cause of that manifestation? We don't go to that. By treating the symptoms, we wait for the body to heal. If it heals well and good, if it doesn't, either we start taking medicines for chronic pain and have those side effects, or you start taking antidepressants or anxiolytics with its own So where do you have to cut? You have to cut at the root, at the expectation. Instead of having expectations and desires, you should have goals. Goals. Goals and targets. And not look at the end result, but look at what you are supposed to do. Enjoy the work, do your best. Whatever you decide to get, you will get. Even in the Gita, it is written very clearly. Karam karam, phal ki chinta mat karo. It is written everywhere. But what do? We take a job, first thing we ask for is the salary package. One person says, okay, you will get a lot to do. You have X salary. Say 100. Other says, okay, I will give you 3 times that salary. Okay, whatever you make me do, I'll do. He says, you come over here, every day you come and sit in the corner and do nothing. How long can you do this? You can't. Our life, we learn, we enjoy by living in the moment. Now let us come to one of the major problems which we all go through every day. The disease of this time, depression, anxiety. What is depression? What is it? If you look at it, some level of depression and anxiety we are all in. Yesterday it has passed. Everybody has a story. Can you do anything about yesterday? Even if you wanted to, you can do nothing about it. It's already over. But if you think about it yesterday, you are bound to have depression. All of you have plans. Bachche bade honge, shaadi karenge, ye karenge, job mein jayenge. उनके लिए पैसा कमाना है, बचाना है, बड़ा कर लेना है, बड़ी गाड़ी लेना है। But do you know that you will wake up tomorrow morning? Are you sure you will wake up in the morning? We don't know whether we will wake up in the morning. Yet, we are making plans 20 years and getting more. Cause of excitement. And what is the actual reality?